Scott Morrison is urging all parents to send their children back to school.
Yeah, the Prime Minister's plea is in direct contradiction to the messaging from state governments who say if children can learn from home, they must not come to school. Kevin Bates is president of the Queensland Teachers Union and he joins us now from Brisbane. I mean, Kevin, a lot of parents are confused this morning. Scott Morrison says our children's education is hanging in the balance. Is he right?
Look, it's a bit ironic when just over a fortnight ago, teachers and principals, the role of schools in all of this was invisible to the Prime Minister. And then today we get this call, following two of the major states announcing very clear arrangements for schools when they start back, Victoria today and Queensland next week. And suddenly the Prime Minister turns all of that on its head and sends a message out to the community that's in complete contradiction to what the premiers of Queensland and Victoria have said to their people.
The Prime Minister is going to argue he has never changed course on this and he has always argued that it is safe. But the mixed messaging between state and federal governments is confusing to parents. So my worry is it puts teachers in such an awful spot. It almost guilts them into going back to work.
Yeah, I think more importantly, it places particularly principals very squarely in the target here because there will be parents who will be saying, the Prime Minister told me I should send my children to school and they're going to have to be the gatekeepers. They're going to have to be the ones managing the resources because very clearly in Queensland and Victoria, social distancing to keep everyone safe from infection has been a primary concern. The workplace health and safety of everybody who work in schools. And from our perspective, this message really creates a dynamic that means that principals will have the invidious role of trying to gatekeep to say that there are some people who shouldn't be coming to school based on the decisions made by the state governments who, after all, are constitutionally responsible for managing schools.
Kevin, who's right?
Look, I think the state governments have struck the right balance. There is absolutely a provision for the children of essential workers and those children who are vulnerable, they're in the care of the state or they've got child protection orders out. Those children are entitled to come to school and teachers will be there to supervise them and ensure that they have work to do. I think the Prime Minister's made a blunder.
My issue is, and I think the PM's done and the government's done a very good job during this whole crisis, I don't know why he needed to enter this fray. I suppose he has every right to. But when he uses language, provocative language, like hanging in the balance, your child's education is hanging in the balance, that's where I go, is that true? Can you answer that question?
I think nothing could be further from the truth. What we know as teachers, remembering that, you know, my 35 years almost of teaching experience tells me that our young people will not suffer from a short period of hiatus around their learning, that teachers are prepared to deliver in a wide variety of ways, not just online and the inequities around online and the failure of our systems to be able to deliver learning into every home is a fundamental, but there are other ways that teachers and principals are prepared to deliver learning. So our young people will continue to receive learning and that has been primary to the state government's concerns. And we've been working with them to ensure that our teachers as professionals will be doing their bit to make sure that learning continues.
Effectively, what you're saying this morning is PM, butt out.
PM, butt out.
Thank you. Good to talk to you. Right.